Hello everyone, welcome back to Sid Meier's Civilization 6. It's been a while, and in that while, Firaxis has come out with an update for, Civ 6, but, Aspyr has not yet ported that to the Mac, so I'm not yet able to experience Australia, the new Civ, or any of those changes. But I figure we might as well finish off this Russia game if we can before that update comes. If it comes soon at all. But yeah, I've been pretty busy, but I've finally managed to make some time here. And I kind of remember what we were doing. I wonder why this farm is not being worked. I guess Mecha thinks it needs this one production more. It wants that one production so much that it would just get rid of two food. Just get off of this tile of seven food and in favor of the five food. Okay. Well, whatever. Yeah, I think we're going for some navy to maybe accompany some nuclear submarines with nukes. That's our end game, as I remember it. And we're also trying to expand the reach of our religion. But let's just get started here. I know Kazan needs another trade route. Another builder. I wonder where he was going. I don't quite remember. Oh, Broly. Why is it? Oh, did it end my turn? Oh. Huh. Well, that's a bit weird. Why is it? Well, I wanted to move my builder, but I guess I clicked too many times on this, and it ended my turn. Oh well. This builder needs to come over here and improve the gypsum. We can maybe sell some more resources, I suppose. And then it might be a pretty good tile to work. Looks like that'll be a 5 production tile. Oh, we found some niter. I don't see any reason to improve that, because we don't need any gunpowder units. Alright, come on. Alright, so what was going on in this city? It was definitely not building an encampment. Oh, well, maybe it was, I don't know. If you don't know, sometimes this indicator lies. Could build a great library in one turn. For Oxford University, that actually sounds quite good. We could get 2 randomly chosen free techs in 6 turns. In 6 turns, eh? We could get, like, replaceable parts for free. potentially. I'd rather get something like rocketry for free. Rocketry or nuclear fission. Or combustion, even. Combustion would be nice. But that's a while away. But if we want to build Oxford, I don't know. What's the highest science city that we have? Because part of the benefit of Oxford is a multiplier on science. So it looks like it's just my capital that produces the most science. But this needs to be near a campus with a university. So I would have to build this right here. Yeah. So in St. Petersburg, I would have to build Oxford on this wheat, which is less than ideal. So I don't know. Kazan is really our biggest production city, so it doesn't seem like a bad idea. We could also just be getting traders, which would be nice. But we could probably do that in some other city. Oxford? I mean, it seems good. We'll get a couple free techs and we'll get some more science. I suppose that's okay. And we can get more traders in Mecca. Yep, that looks like the main thing we want to do here. Let's see, does Mecca really need another trade route? Not really. Probably Tula. Tula could use another trade route. Okay. No, the housing is capped, but we're gonna get a neighborhood, so yeah. We'll head over to Tula. We've got an apostle. A debater. Interesting. Alright, so we're just sending all these apostles up this path. I see. Can we afford another apostle? What's the cost so far? It's 350. Okay. I wonder what the scout is doing. I guess just protecting from barbarians, making sure barbarians don't spawn. This is an orator, so he's supposed to convert Carthage, I'm assuming. That'll do. Another crossbow? Doesn't look like it. There's an encampment down there. I guess we'll go root that out. Oh, there is this archer which I could combine with the crossbowman. Let's make our way down. Try to do that. Yep. Tolstoy has nowhere to deposit those great works. No, we can go to Tula. Ah, okay. That was not an efficient walk. Could have taken the road. That's okay. That was weird. Alright, I'll definitely gain some sources to make buying their... Oh, they're building Oxford. Heh. That looks like almost done. Is it even worth... I think we're gonna lose this battle if they're already building that, so... I don't think there's any reason to do that. Go for Oxford right now. We'll certainly lose. Even with the insane amount of production that Kajan has. I mean, just look at that. Like, it's pretty much almost done, you know? I doubt they're slacking off on trying to build it. Proselytizers here. Yeah. Let's convert Tokyo. Is this a... Wait. Okay, that's a translator. That's important. Debater. Okay, we need to heal this debater up. And a translator. Finished Mont Saint-Michel. Okay. Oh, we're no longer suzerain of Yerevan. That's significant. Yeah, we have that Carthage bonus. That's right. That's why we have so many trade routes. So do we want to overtake Japan here? Yerevan? I think so. Yep. Alright. I'll take it. Don't need Niter. Okay. Oh, is that? I see this encampment lost a lot of health. Is that, what that blast was? Don't know. Alright. Probably an armory. Could just purchase the armory. I wonder if that's worth it. Sure, I'll purchase the armory. Although, it would probably be better to purchase the traders, because their units... they're cheaper to buy and just more annoying to have to produce, I guess. Because we have so much production that we can like one turn traders in any city? So we're kind of wasting production. Or at least having to overflow production when we build traders. So I suppose I should have spent my money on that, but that's okay. I already did it, so whatever. Let's get the harbor buildings going now. Oh, and we already got all the traders. Okay. Well. Kajan's kind of run out of things to build other than military units. Let's see, maybe invest in great people? This would be a really nice great general, just for the ability to speed up my tanks when I get them. Other than that, Rockefeller might be nice just to guarantee some oil for me, but it looks like I'm already gonna get him in 10 turns. Looks like, yeah. So it's not a big deal. Alan Turing is not that pressing. So I suppose I could get some encampment training. That would give some gold as well. Seems like a good idea. We might be able to beat out that AI in terms of great people points, great general points. No, this mecha's in the pretty much the same boat. I guess we'll get a market though. Actually, we're gonna get banking next turn, in which case I will, at which point I will build banks in Mecca and Kajan, and purchase an apostle. Alright, probably need to send this to a different city. Oh, and I accidentally started 3 trade routes in Kajan, which is kind of overkill. I would say. Mecca. No, Mecca's got some trade routes. Cairo? Yeah, we'll send one trade route to Cairo. So, we'll a trade route out of Mecca and then send some trader elsewhere. Probably Vologda? Or whatever. Probably needs another trade route. Just gonna assume. Wait, what? What did I just... I could have sworn I just moved this builder up there. Oh, did I move the archer up? Oh. Losing my mind. Another great work. That's great. I suppose I'll just, while I'm here, convert Smolensk. I don't suppose I could heal in neutral territory. I don't really know the physics behind healing religious units. I suppose I could test. I don't know. Thank you. I got spread my Eastern Orthodoxy up to Japan. About time. Alright, we're gonna need some food in Dula because we're about to get a neighborhood. So I'll prioritize that. Guess I'll explore over there. Seems like a good idea. Not a lot of room for conversion over there, so this order should just head over to Japan, really. Oh yeah, and we have the ability to purchase another apostle. I might as well. Right? I don't really have much other use for faith other than buying great people. Is not really a big concern because it's pretty expensive to buy great people. Yeah. I don't know. I've never actually pursued a strategy of using faith to buy great people. It seems like at a certain point the great people get so underpowered in the late game. Like at some point, like the great scientists, they give eurekas to certain techs, are just so useless because you have so much science per turn already. And you already have like eurekas for all the texts that you really need. Right, I'm not sure what's the most pressing need right now for... You have a debater and another debater, right? This is a translator. Okay. Looks like we could use another proselytizer. Tizer? And I could also send him overseas. It seems like a better idea than trying to walk all the way around here. Yeah. I think I have a good amount of movement when I'm embarked. Let's see. Do, right? Oh, open borders ended with Spain. Hey, nice. Yep, I'll do it. Not a huge price to pay at all. So yeah, we'll get proselytizer and we'll prepare to send him overseas. Yep. Oh yeah, and Germany finished their Oxford. So it's a good thing I canceled that. So wait, Big Ben doesn't appear to be available. Right? I mean, where would we even be able to build it? We don't have any rivers, right? We could build it in Mecca if we were able to. if someone else hadn't already built it, which it definitely looks like someone already has. I wonder who. It's probably like Germany or something. Yeah. Oh, right, right. I don't even have Big Ben tech. Jeez. I looked over and I saw, like, oh, you can build a bank. So I assumed I had the Big Ben tech. That was pretty silly. Jeez. Not much protection in Mecha compared to Kajan. Okay, we have the opportunity to get another district here. Is it just one more district? Oh, actually two. Huh. And I kinda wanna get a Lavra just because it's quick to build. Yeah, maybe, like, I could actually, like, win a religious victory here. For now. Seems like that's a possibility. How well our faith game is going. How much housing in Vlad? We could probably use more production. Vlogda. Just gonna purchase that monument. The lack of it is bugging me. Could get another lava here, but I don't feel like that's worth it. This city, we could use more builders, actually. Yeah. That glorious Russian army. chariots and archers. Guess we're not hearing that bit of music. No? Still not my religion. That's too bad. So the proselytizer continues on, and I'm thinking it'd be a lot more strategic to hit cities like Magdeburg, these bigger cities. I think that's where proselytizer is going to matter the most, whereas we can follow it up with translator in these tiny cities where pressure swings mean a lot more. suppose what I mean by that is... Oh, shoot. He's got a... an Inquisitor in his friendly territory. Better get out of there. I suppose what I mean by that is, in these bigger cities, it's harder to convert, just with pure religious pressure from apostles like this one, translator. Whereas if we have a proselytizer, it acts like an inquisitor in that it just, you know, totally eradicates the religious pressure of other religions. But normally an apostle would not do anything with the other religious pressure. It just adds religious pressure to your own religious pressure of your own religion. So I think it's stronger to use the proselytizer in the bigger cities and the non-proselytizers in the smaller ones. That's what you get when you act, when you attack outside your religious, your home territory. You're also failing horribly because Islam is the majority religion in the city that you're standing right next to. What are we, Oh yeah, propaganda. No need for that. My people love me. Oh, jeez. That's a lot of inquisitors. Insert joke about Spanish Inquisition here. I'm a bit wary about that encampment. Oh yeah, it's a good thing I didn't move on to that marsh, because that's kind of what I was planning on doing. Actually, I would hate this crossbowman to shoot my apostle and just kill it. So I'll try to avoid that. Oh. Right, I was trying to get back into my own borders. Oops. Alright, just send the debater overseas. Might as well. Right. Yeah, 5 move. It's a lot better. And build a seaport? Yeah. So I want to focus back on Big Ben. Well, I think we would have to build Big Ben in Mecca, like on this tile. It's a plains. This is a floodplains, right? Yeah. This is a floodplains wheat. And this is just wheat. No, it's also floodplains wheat. And this has got to be floodplains as well, right? Yeah. So, we would have to build Big Ben on this tile in either Mecca or Cairo, and I suppose it would be Mecca, because... Oh, jeez. Cairo has way more production. I wonder why. They just have all the mines, I guess. That's a good point. Mecca doesn't really have... many mines. It's really all about the food, I guess, in Mecca. But there's still so much more to build in Cairo that I feel like we should build Big Ben in Mecca. We'll have to see, it's a tricky thing there. It's definitely not happening in St. Petersburg, though. Because you can't... you can't displace luxury resources or strategic resources for that matter. What is gonna be a seaport? Was Cristo Redentor? Well, that's not gonna happen. Costs too much, and it's not really vital to our game plan here. Could use an extra amenity here. Although I could, can't buy the arena. Okay, let's just put production to it. It's too bad we can't build Big Ben in Kajan. But that would probably, like, if we had built market district in a place with Big Ben in mind, then Big Ben would have to be built on hills, and that would void my Ruhr Valley mines, which would kind of be sad. Let's get more encampment training. They're 5 turns away, but I wonder if we can get there first. That would be funny. We might be able to. You never know, these projects are actually quite good. No, I think we're gonna be too slow on the draw, but can't hurt to try. And we need generals anyway. Still getting shreked because they're attacking into outside of their territory. Definitely want to avoid this samurai. To stick around. This is going to be a lot better traveling by sea. Plus, we might be a bit more a bit less vulnerable to these enemy inquisitors and whatnot. Is that... Spain spawns an inquisitor for Islam. Why? Oh, you're the founder of Islam? Oh, I thought you were the founder of Catholicism. I guess that's Germany's religion. Yeah, founded in Heidelberg. Huh. All right. Islam founded by Spain. All right. It's good to know. I thought I was just laughing because I was like, "Oh, Spanish are spawning Islamic inquisitors, but they're following Catholicism. Actually, they're not. They founded Islam. More encampment training. Hey, that provided a lot of free person points. We might be able to win that fight. I might actually build Big Ben in Cairo, because we just have so much more production in Cairo than in Mecca. Yeah. So, we need to build something here in one turn. It could be like a builder. But what's a builder really gonna do? I don't know. Oh, we could improve things up here. Yeah, we'll just spend one turn building a builder. I might also be able to overflow some production into Big Ben next turn. That's troublesome. We don't have the bank in Mecca yet, but we could buy it next turn. I know I've already put production into it, but I'd like to start on Big Ben next turn. So I'm gonna switch here and just buy the bank here next turn, because we'll have the money. And I keep forgetting that Big Ben doubles your currency, so I should not be spending money. But I'll spend money just to, well, we could put it off. We could put off Big Ben for one turn. That would allow me to build, like, something more important in Cairo, like one of these districts, so probably an encampment. Or a theater square, Yeah, we could do with a theater square, I suppose. There's no wonders to build it by, sadly, but we can put it in the desert. That's awfully nice, because it's not gonna mess up any yields, tile yields. Now, yep, probably a district. Build a district here. Could get in an industrial zone, but I'm thinking more like along the lines of an entertainment complex, just to entertain these three cities. Sounds like a good idea, actually. Entertainment complex. Okay. And, so I could actually go, like, right here. I'm gonna put the entertainment complex right here. Alright. Seems like a good spot. I didn't want to buy any tiles because, well, okay, well, I could have bought a tile for it, but I didn't. Oh well. Should really send Apostle up to convert Kabul. They do want religious conversion. Yeah. give us open borders. Oh, right, because she's denouncing me. She won't let me in. It's too bad. So I could steal money, I could pillage their industrial zone? Pillage their industrial zone, eh? Steel combustion is actually good, because I do need that. The Eureka. I'm not gonna be extracting an artifact, not anytime soon. Steel tech boost is good, siphon fonts is good, or pillage buildings is also good. Well, stealing the tech boost is only going to come into play later on, because I still need to research all the techs before combustion. It's gonna be, quite a few turns before I can research combustion, so it's not going to be immediately useful. But maybe sabotaging the production, that's immediately useful. It cuts off some production, or, Germany. It does have a Hansa up there, so it's not that big of a deal for him. But it does ruin the production inside Heidelberg, at the very least. I think we should start with a low profile stealing money, though. Plus, that will be doubled with Big Ben if I can get it, or if someone hasn't already built it. And it has more chance of actually succeeding, so let's just try that, and we might actually get promoted from doing it. I don't think you get promotion from siphon funds, though. I'm not sure. I don't know how exactly that works. We can purchase another apostle, eh? I'd rather wait. Wait. Actually. No, we'll stockpile faith and wait until this Lavra and the temple is done here. Yeah. Seems like a good idea. England declared war on Germany, eh? It's a pretty big battle. Oh. You're coming to me because you lost a battle against one of my apostles. Well, I'm gonna be spreading to you. Oh. And I'm going to be spreading to you, so ignore both of them. Eh. Wow, we even converted this two-pop city, which we didn't have any pressure in before. That's funny. Don't have to actually deal with that. Alright. That was just... we just got ideology, right? Yeah. Okay, so there's economics, and the next step is... yeah, just pretty much research anything you want, and go up to combustion. Someone's already built Alhambra, so that's not a thing, and I'm pretty sure someone's built Forbidden City, I'm pretty sure. Actually, I think it was... oh! It's not built yet? Germany's building it. Huh. I wonder if we could build it. In Kazan, perhaps. Let's just look. It would have to be adjacent to the city, so we could build it right here. That sounds good. Well, let's see if we can actually be successful in that. spy looks like the best idea here. Sure. Looks like we have a chance to get that. I could purchase this, and I have been saying that I shouldn't purchase things. But this is like low cost. I'm gonna make the another exception there, but I'm definitely going to just build that temple with raw production. Do we even have any oranges yet? I wonder. No, so that's actually gonna be unique. Then I should prioritize improving onto it. This is a proselytizer, right? And a debater. Okay. So I could maybe debate some of these inquisitors. Although that's kind of a stretch. We would not want to debate the Inquisitors inside their own home territory. Alright, this is going nowhere, so... Oh, jeez. Well, that apostle might be dead. If the samurai decides to have a word. Have a word with my apostle. Alright, we're... I don't know if it heals in friendly territory. I know for sure that apostles can heal within your own holy sites. All right. Oh. Convert any of your cities? Your cities are still under the same religions. Yep, he built Big Ben. But has anyone built Forbidden Palace? I don't think there's Forbidden City, that is. Forbidden Palace is the Civ 5 wonder. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get that. Forbidden City is really good. It's a free wild card slot, so that's pretty much just as good as Big Ben, I'd say. If not better, but the doubling treasury is really good. It's too bad he got Big Ben the turn I was ready to start building it. I mean, it's better than if I, like, started building it and then he built it on the same turn that I was about to finish it. Stock exchange? No. Came in training in 3 turns, though. Hmm. How has he progressed in building this? Oh, I can't tell because I don't even have vision. I think I've lost. I don't think I'm getting that great general. It's too bad. But I think I'm just gonna have to accept that. Alright, that's a pretty cheap buy. So I'll take it. I have two art museums, so I don't need another one for the moment. I'm gonna get an archaeologist museum then. Yeah. Oh, and that gives... that gives great artist points anyway. Which is interesting. Alright. Archaeological museum. In here I'll take a stock exchange. Get some more money. Money's always good. Is this our counter spy? I think so. Oh yeah, prioritize this, and that's extra, you know, an extra luxury, so it'll be more amenities. You can have that tile, because there's no way Mecha's working it. Germany was really angry about my religious wishing. Oh, thank goodness the samurai decided not to molest my awesome bosses. Right, I suppose I'll head north. We're not safe. Oh, we're not safe up here either. Probably gonna die then. And this guy is also probably gonna die. This is the debater. Just kind of scouting with the debater. His main focus is trying to find enemy religious units. By the way, which... Oh right, Yerevan wanted me to build a theater square, and that's what I did. Alright. That's good. The city as well. Well, they almost converted it. Of course. Well, looks like Japan is going away. Here's our great artist. So they're all gonna be portraits, apparently. It's kind of bad. Because all of our current works of art are not portraits. If you don't know how to theme artwork, you know, get a theming bonus, basically have to have all the same, all artwork of the same type. So this one's religious, these ones are sculptures. You have to have them all the same type in one museum, and they have to be created by different people. A what? Yes, a what? You can purchase an apostle? Yeah. And we have room for another district. And we will have room for another one after that, because we're about to grow to 13 population. So let's just be liberal with what we choose here, and probably, I mean, a campus would be nice. Maybe an entertainment complex, first and foremost. Oh, but we already have an entertainment complex here that's entertaining. Looks like these four cities: Moscow, Mecca, Tula, and St. Petersburg. So Tula's not gonna. Well, Tula could help entertain Smolensk. That's true. Actually, I should try to. Wait. Oh. There's no way to actually reach Smolensk with a regional bonus from Tula. Or from any city for that matter. So. That's kinda off the cards. I was considering building an industrial zone to try to affect Smolensk, but it's not gonna happen. So. Could be an encampment. Let's go for the long-term play of building a campus. Why can't we build in the desert? Those tiles are just not swapped correctly, I see. Yeah, I'd rather build a campus in the desert. And, plus one adjacency is fine. It's good. Another builder. Ah, too bad. Didn't finish the builder this turn. That's quite the cost to upgrade that. Actually a significant trade route right there, but I just sent out a trade route for 5 production. This city had 10 production before per turn. That's a significant boost to production to Smolensk. 50% boost, in fact. So, yeah, be powerful. I lost two apostles in one turn. Sucks. But that's what happens when you meet Spain trying to push their religious ideals. I'd rather not enter Spanish territory to try to convert it. Because I know how that's gonna end. Going to be Spanish inquisitors everywhere. But I don't know, maybe I could just have one inquisitor. Oh, plus we're a debater, so it's not too bad. Well, I'm going to try it. Just a quick conversion. Send the proselytizer up to convert Magdeburg. And maybe Mainz. And Aachen. I don't know. Just do some damage to the German religion. Democracy. Ah! My religion stands strong in the face of your inquisitors. I hope that one health barbarian samurai is... Oh. I'm just gonna ignore. I hope that one health barbarian samurai is causing trouble for the Spanish inquisitors. Yes, so we have communism. We will adopt it immediately. Perfect. Now, which card did we just lose? I'm not sure. It might have been Medina Quarter. I wouldn't be surprised. Let's see. Yeah, it was Medina Quarter. We really just need to build, like, more neighborhoods and stop relying on this nonsense. We don't need to grow in Mecca, don't need to grow in Kajan either. Well... Yeah. In the cities we need to grow in, we can just build neighborhoods. Because I'd rather switch to collectivization? Perhaps. Seems like the best idea. We have the option logistics, that's good. Veterancy, be good. Just looking for peacetime policies to adopt. Yep. Veterancy sounds good. All right. Choose a civic. Now we could again go for totalitarianism or lightning warfare, but well, more pressing need is archaeologists and zoos, I suppose. So yeah, seems like the ideal thing to go for the moment. Our capital, what are we gonna do? Oh yeah. Build a navy at this point in time. Seems like a good idea. Yep, that's what we're gonna do actually. Build submarines. Submarine armadas. Could get ironclads. A mixture of both, really. I mean, let's see. We got melee strength of 60. Range strength 75. Yeah, a mix of both, really. Is what we're looking for. And of course, the ironclads are take less production than the building submarines. But of course the submarines are the precursor to nuclear submarines, so there's that to think about. Yeah. I think we'll start out with a an ironclad because it can move farther, move faster. Wait, did I get that right? Yeah, I think it moves faster. Oh, that was a waste. St. Petersburg cannot work those crabs. Oh well. At least it's gonna give housing. I think it will. Get another neighborhood, perhaps? Oh, and of course, every time we switch away from a merchant republic, we're losing a couple of trade routes, which is too bad. Good place to have a king? Neighborhood? No loot, eh? Did we fail? We must have if he doesn't have loot, or she. It's probably a she. But on foot. Well, this agent is not experienced, so I'll take, I'll take the middle route, sure, vehicle. Oh, success? What? It said no loot. Well, it worked. That's good. I got 200 monies. Paint your portraits. So we probably need more translators, I'd say. Oh shoot. He has not been gaining health there. I'm pretty sure he has to be inside a friendly holy site. Get a translator, yeah. Now, this is the debater. Gonna head around, maybe. I don't want to use this last spread because that will kill the apostle. I'd rather use the apostle to battle some enemy religious units, so we're gonna head over here and then maybe head into German territory. Oh, of course. Better not attack me. He's probably going to kill me. That's too bad. That's really stupid. Take care of your barbarians, guys. Why can't you have happiness in your realms? It's because you're too barbaric. You're conquering all these enemy cities. Well, let's see what's gonna happen. Sure, I'll take it. I'll take your furs. And 29 gold. Yeah, okay. Barbarian artillery. This is cutting-edge technology. Nice, the conquistadors went away. Artillery's making a mad dash for my apostle. Hey. What's up with that? Alright, colonialism is done. Don't need anything new there. Why did we discover all of this? Oh, we got pushed out of English territory? Was that it? Did we have open borders before? Oh, we had open borders with Germany, and then we lost them. So the heavy chariot got pushed from, like, up there to down here. That's funny. Alright. Now, it looks like it's embarking time. Yeah. Need another neighborhood. Feels like kind of a waste. Translator? Head out. Oh man, this neighborhood is gonna take forever to build. In this city. It's because Smolensk is so bad. I mean, I want to build a neighborhood, so I will. Oh, it wasn't enough. Come on. Well, they're gonna be my suzerain, and I'm gonna get double experience. No need to spend these envoys, though. Just save them up, just in case. That'll finish off those neighborhoods quicker. Oh, oops. Didn't mean to go there. Yeah. English Navy is a galley. All right, so proselytizer. Oh, nice. It's instantly my religion. That's good. Again, we don't want to use the spread, because we're on the last one. We have the ability to get another fossil, right? Yep. I'll take it. So, we never got the last general. We're not gonna get this general either, but I really don't care, because I'm not gonna have atomic era military units. Not really. And I might have information era units, that is, I might have a modern armor, but probably not. I actually got Forbidden City, that's really good. I would like some more. Oh, yeah, we get some guaranteed oil. That'll help out. Well, I was talking about something, but I was distracted. I would really like a harbor. Eh. 234 turns until growth, eh? Wow. That's like no time at all. Wait, weren't we just building a neighborhood here? What's this? Oh, this is a campus, that's right. Alright. We don't need any more housing here. No need for a neighborhood. No need to waste your time. Yeah, so at this point, encampment training is completely useless, basically. Cosmetics? It's not gonna be that great. Three random Eurekas again? Like, this late in the game, it's not, it's pretty underwhelming. I'd rather get a stock exchange at this point. And we have space for another district. I don't have an industrial zone. That's an idea. An industrial zone, Or could get an entertainment complex. Kazan is really the only city that is not benefiting from it, is not going to benefit from an entertainment complex. Oh, and Smolensk, but I don't know, I don't think it's a pressing need for any sort of entertainment complex. So the other option is an industrial zone, which I think is a good idea. just put it where it's not gonna mess with any farm adjacency. So the wild card slot. Could get Medina Quarter again. Don't need liberalism. I'm thinking like free market, maybe. Maybe campus and industrial zone adjacency bonus. I don't know how beneficial that would be. Probably not that great. Could get like frescoes or something. Maybe not though. Extra science. There's a thought. I could adopt one of these in the wildcard slot. I've never actually done something like that, because they're actually not that powerful, the diplomatic cards, but I don't know, all of these cards are pretty useless to me right now. I mean, let's see. Continent. I have 3 cities that are not on my continent. I'm just looking at this colonial taxes policy, which is not that great. Yeah. Interest of just making a decision here. Oh, hey, press gangs, right? So we're building ironclads. Yeah, that's actually like really good. Okay. That'll do. Since we're building ironclad armadas. Really use, well, Cold War, yeah. Once we're finished with natural history, probably Cold War. Yeah. So, another spy to spy on another nation. Probably Spain, because they seem particularly annoying. Try Kyoto. Oh, I mean, I could look at the rankings. Yeah, I mean, doing well in culture, so I guess I could try to knock them down by taking some of their great works in Kyoto. Although that's probably not gonna happen. Proselytizer? Sure. We'll just alternate between proselytizer and translator at this point. there no religious units? Come on, bring it on, Germany. Conversions in. Alright, the debater. Try healing. Oh, still not enough. Jeez. Needs a lot of pressure. Well, that's too bad. Not skip turn, but just sleep. Good amount of yield. Oh, jeez. A frigate. That'll instantly blow me out of the water. Let's see if he actually succeeds in doing that. Or, like, tries to. That's what I'm trying to say. Yerevan. Come back to me, Yerevan. Nice. It will always be mine. Religion's doing well. Seems to be. So we have the opportunity to get some archaeologists. Should be good. And as I said, the next thing to go for is Cold War. Can build submarines faster like that. I think. We got submarines at electricity. Right. So we can build submarines faster. Submarines are better than ironclads. But we do need some ironclads to actually take cities. Because ranged units cannot take cities, of course. Alright, so we've finished, what was it? District. No. Wait, what did we finish here? Don't know. Don't remember. Oh, right, I think it was a stock exchange. Hermitage? Oh, that kind of sucks. I have to get rid of a mine to do it. I don't know about that. It's a nice amount of works of art that I can store there. I wouldn't have to worry about building any more art museums. So it could be good. I could just build it on the sheep tile. I don't need food in Kajan anymore because we don't need to grow. In fact, we're gonna grow in 5 turns anyway, probably because of the amount of trade routes I have. Yeah. Could also get Christo Redentor. But no. No. Pretty useless. Hermitage would probably be better, yeah. In terms of the culture that I could get, or the tourism that I could get, that is. Well, bye-bye, sheep. and Perhaps could get a theater square next? I'm gonna... Oh, well, that's not what I meant, but it doesn't change the fact that I'm not gonna have enough movement to get up on that hill. Let's get one more builder here. That is four envoys, that's quite a bit. But again, I'd rather save them, I think. Although this is, like, a significant amount of gold that I could get just by adding two envoys there. I'm gonna do that. It's gonna give a lot of gold. Because I do have a lot of commercial hubs. Oh, what are you? Oh, you're the one who stole the gold. I thought you were supposed to get promoted. That's too bad. Let's go spy on Germany again. To Aachen. Wait, what about Heidelberg? Yeah, Heidelberg. I'd rather go to the place that already has sources. Wait, I have to establish sources again? Well, I'm gonna go to Heidelberg again. This is the holy city of Catholicism, by the way, that I'm standing next to. Yeah. I could just go over and try to convert it. It would probably be a failure. Just a guess. Well, it's not going to be a failure in that it's going to wipe out all the opposing pressure, but. I think Heidelberg's too big for me to be able to, you know, convert it. In one go. Let's try to convert Aachen, right? Yeah, wasn't enough, but at least we get rid of a pressure point. Aachen will not be providing pressure. I'm gonna use this translator to convert finish Aachen off. Actually, Aachen is pretty close to converting by itself. Might do that. That'd be nice. Okay, try to heal. Antiquity sites, everywhere. Wow, actually everywhere. Yeah. Buy archaeologists? Yeah, you can. It's very expensive though, so I don't think I'll be doing that. Well, the frigate did not attack my heavy chariot, so that's good. Heavy chariot from antiquity. Yes, finally, and we're now their suzerain. That's good. We get an extra +2 production in our encampment districts. Should help.
when building military units.
Oh shoot, the frigate came back. Dang. So we got the ironclad, it's nice. Could build a frigate? I don't know about that. Should we build a frigate that upgrades into, I'm guessing it upgrades into a battleship? Probably. Yeah. Could build a frigate. I don't know. It's pretty weak for this time period. I don't think I'm gonna waste my time trying to get that. Just get some more ironclads. And then after building this next ironclad, I'll build submarines, because then we're gonna get international waters and those submarines will really be churned out quite quickly. Library as well, and then go into an encampment. Yeah, sure. In fact, I'll swap that. Take the encampment right there. Yeah, just to be on the road, really. Take an archaeologist? Sure. Ah, the debater healed. That's good. Nice. Purchase another apostle. Yes, the debater. Keep heading deeper into enemy territories. Well, this heavy chariot's kind of screwed. Maybe not. Maybe not. 19 population in St. Petersburg. Totally unnecessary. Well, actually, that's gonna do it for now. I'm gonna finish off this session here. It's good to be back in Sid Meier's Civilization 6. And I like the way this game is going. Seems pretty strong. Got good production in a lot of these cities. And the religious game is, I mean, it's pressing forward. I don't usually push this hard for religion. Like, I'll usually just completely neglect my faith and I'll end up with, like, 3,000 faith. Like, by the end of the game. But I think I'm using the faith effectively here. Now, well, if I were better at handling faith, I would have headed towards theocracy at some point to utilize faith to buy to purchase units and do domination like that. But I don't know. I guess that kind of gameplay is altogether foreign for me. But I think this is a good way to go about religion, though. Just like view it as like a side. I don't know, like a side thing that gives a few just passive bonuses, like, you know, you just look at this, you know, I'm gaining some science from it, you know, gaining a bit of culture here and there, some amenities, you know, just some passive benefits, and at the same time, if you have a lot of faith per turn, you can just also, you know, slowly build up some army of apostles to just try and spread your religion and get closer to very situational, but, you know, regardless, like, existence, you know, a victory condition. That is, like, usually you don't win, you don't often win a religious victory, but, you know, if you play like this in enough games, then, you know, maybe 10% of the time you'll win a religious victory. Just because you're kind of persistent with that faith-buying apostles, I suppose. Anyway, like, if we don't win a religious victory, of course, the game plan's still the same. Just go up to nukes, and then get nuclear submarines, and it should be pretty easy to just nuke all the capitals and take him with, like, some strategically placed tanks. Yeah. Anyway, it's gonna do it. By the way, I'm really sorry about the mouse desyncs that they kind of happen on, like, all of my videos. I'm not sure how to fix them, but, well, what can you do, really? Anyway, yep. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope I'll see you next time. Take care.